Okay, welcome back to your screens. You're watching another episode of Saloon Talk, guys. You're watching Upper TV, and thank you for tuning in. The show runs every Sunday from 8 p.m. to 9 p.m. So make sure you tell a friend to tell a friend to tell a friend. And of course, I'm not going to waste any more time. I'm going to go right into the topic of the day. Today's topic is hassles of a youth in Kampala. If you know your youth out there and your life hasn't really been easy, you've always been there and your coin you want to make in your pocket, it has not come easy. What are some of the hassles that the Kampala youth goes through today? And maybe you're going to pick a leaf of what we're going to be talking about. My beautiful guests are already in the building. I'm going to be joining them right about now. But before we go down to our social media platform, that is Upper Television Uganda, hashtag Saloon Talk. Make sure you give us the topic, whatever you want to comment on the topic, and we're going to be giving you right here. And of course, I'm joining my beautiful ladies, the youth themselves. As I sit down, they're going to be telling us their names, what they do. And yeah, we can start from there. Okay. Hi, guys.
Hi.
How are you doing? Nga, you're looking good.
Thank
I thought I'm going to be the only one, but I'm having a...
How
about you guys are looking better? Have you seen this one?
She looks like a goddess.
But queen. Okay, Pastor, say hi to the people who are watching us right now. You're on Urban TV. And what you do, then we can start from there.
Okay, Option Queen Official, aka Queen Bianca. And I'm a party host, a makeup artist. I think that's all.
Okay. Hi, everyone. How are you? I'm called Dance Mamweta. I'm a dancer from Uganda. I'm a choreographer, dance teacher, and a hype girl on stage.
Okay, guys, as you can see, I'm in the midst of talented youth. Like, the topic of today is hassles of a youth in Kampala. So you are youth out there, and you're going through some hassles, and you're like, am I the only one? You're not the only one. We're going to be telling you a few things of what the youth goes through in Kampala today. And of course, being that we are ladies, I wish we had a male perspective of this. But anyway, we are going to be getting a male perspective as the show goes on. But I'm going to start right away because, guys, I know your story is something that somebody can even write a novel. And for this, there are some stories in Kampala. Someone tells you their hassle and you're like, yeah, this chick has really hassled. This girl has really gone through miles. So that's my way to, as I starting as a dancer, in Uganda, in Kampala, what are some of those things that you have encountered, like the problems, leave alone the sweet things? I want to hear the problems first. Some of those issues you have gone through as a dancer when you were starting up in Kampala.
Okay, while I was starting up, I branded myself as a solo dancer. And that was one thing that people didn't want to accept. They wanted me to be in a group. For someone to hire you for a job, maybe on stage or a music video or any other project, they want you to come as a group. And that was quite a big challenge on my side. I wouldn't get jobs, and that was like my dream, to get jobs and work and expose my talent out there. Then also underpayment. People don't want to pay in this industry. It is like putting
the same,
a pin.
Like Uganda don't send you with that kamani.
That kamani doesn't come easy. Most especially on us creatives, the dancers most especially. We're working, towards that goal and achieving more in our, talent.
Okay, Queen, being a party host, you have met a lot of celebrities in Kampala, even those that just come just for the night. You have hosted a lot of parties. What are some of those... Now, since Marita told us about a problem, I'm going to be like, problem, solution, something like that. So,
solution.
Okay, not solution.
There's no solution.
Okay, not solution, you get what I mean, the positive part of it.
Yeah.
So, what are some of those positive parts you got being, at a party host in Kampala?
Positive parts? I think money. Like payment, the more you brand yourself, is the more you get money.
Pay.
Yeah,
that's true.
Yeah, I think those are the. That's the only. No, those are the only positive.
Yeah.
I thought she was gonna tell me posting parties at night, find some rich,
I know you meet them, but
guy.
Such things have also disadvantages.
At a point,
so okay.
Leave alone.
Okay. You get fame. At a point, good payment, through the branding. I think that's it. Me, that's all I get. No, that's not the good side. No, abasajja, no. Like, omanya abasajja batusanga bifongebe ate batutya. Like, challenges nyingi. No, wagamba you get a rich guy, aja kukosanga one night stand. So, echa abasajja.
This statement goes to both of you. Abasajja wagamba, finding a girl more so in a club, in a lounge, whichever party place it is, more so especially in Gayamba Neneti, or like, I can see me through, or something. So like they always have this perception, oh, those girls are not like wife materials. What is that thing that they are wrong about you that they think they know?
Like, how do you judge a book by its cover?
Its cover, tell her.
Like, how do you?
Yeah, like,
how do you, are you God?
Okay, you have to just leave them to judge you. Exactly. That's all I think. You have to do your thing. That's all I can say.
Not until.
People never stop judging, my dear. However much you put on a gomasi and you go out, still they will judge you for something.
In their defense, they say, okay, yes, these girls, they dress up like this. Yes, don't judge a book by its cover. Everybody knows that. So they say that they approach them and they get to know them and they are actually way worse than they thought they were.
No, some even get good women.
Exactly.
Some even get good women.
And they trash them away.
Yeah, no. Like, if a guy is serious with you, obviously, he won't care about your past. Yeah.
Exactly.
He just concentrate on the future and the person he met in person. Mm. Like, one-on-one word, I think it's...
The personality, yeah, and the character of the person.
Yeah,
that's
I think that's better.
Okay. Mm-hmm. I can see. the cabals is turning, and I'm about to switch it up a little bit, but don't get scared, just be honest with me. If you feel like you don't want to answer it, you can be like, Queen, like I said, being a party host, you have seen, like you said, you've seen a lot. People, you've created your brand. So like, have you ever fallen in love with the man you met in the bar?
Yeah, but it's always, you know, it's very it's
in tears.
Very complicated. Like, it ends up in tears. That's all I can say.
So what I'm asking, don't you be knowing? Okay, like, leave alone, like, her hosting in the bar. Even you, my waiter, when you go out, now you're a dancer.
Yeah.
You're meeting your fellow dancers. And they're all like, never met a dancer.
Let me tell you, that's the line I first drew for myself, you know? Like, I shouldn't ever date a dancer. We are all hustling the same. We are all in the industry doing the same thing. I mean... Doesn't make sense. I need
leave alone. Okay, yeah, you let me say you're not hosting. Mm. You're just going out with your friends. You let me say we have all gone out right now. Me, you and Queen have gone out to a lounge, to a bar, and we're getting our own drinks. Mm. Everybody's like, oh, those girls are cool. Everybody wants to be with us. Mm. And then like we get these responsible men.
Yeah.
Do those men be responsible even when they are not in the bar? Or are they
no, responsible men are everywhere.
They are everywhere. And
but I think it's just time. Fate to meet the person, like the person who loves you. Like, it's fate. Mm. It's not about the place and the location.
It's only,
even some people get prostitutes from the street and they marry them.
Mm.
Like, I know one pastor who did that, my dear.
Ooh,
yeah.
A pastor?
Yeah, a pastor, I'm telling you.
The same pastors, they be looking for... That's like, there's like a story I had, there's a time on Twitter I was going through. Sometime back, there's a pastor they caught in a banagamba. I've come to preach to the lost souls.
No, there you go. They also have fun, as long as they don't take alcohol. Because
okay,
I see most of them.
Commercial break. As we come back, we are still with the beautiful ladies in the building, and we are the youth. Like I told you, today is specifically we are targeting the youth, so make sure you seated in, you are stacked to your seat right about now. Let us first go for a short commercial break. When we come back, we still have